This letter reads, which I received here in this office, Cox was first, you were next, you treacherous, worthless, F-U-C-K-I-N-G, dead, slag.
Another death threat sent to another MP. This time Anna Soubry, the former Tory minister, but she's not alone. Security used to be just part of the debate about law and order. Now it refers to how MPs can stay safe.
You don't know who might turn up from somewhere else. That is the problem, and that's why so many of us have been really reluctant to do what we used to do, these sort of open drop-in surgeries. I used to do meet the teams, and yeah, you just couldn't do that.
And MPs are now being urged to take extraordinary precautions when they're out in public. What sort of advice are MPs getting from the police?
The kind of advice that really restricts our campaigning, so not going out alone, not going out in the dark. Those are all necessary, unfortunately, at the moment, but it does make a winter campaign very difficult to conduct.
It's shocking, isn't it, that the police are telling female MPs that they can't go out alone?
I suppose it is shocking, but actually we are used to that now. It's just part of our everyday lives.
Rosie Duffield is chair of Labour's female parliamentary party. She believes the abuse and threats will have a lasting, damaging effect.
I really worry because I work with 50-50 Parliament. We're trying to get more women into this place, and this is the direct opposite of what we want the image of Parliament to be, that it isn't a safe place for women.
Please have you not been arrested?
A protest on Whitehall today. The bitterness of the Brexit crisis has now led to some MPs deciding to quit.
Continuously abusive emails. Every morning, obviously, you know, you turn the emails on and there's more stuff that is rude, offensive. And I think actually a couple of weeks ago, my office referred something to me and they said, oh, I don't think this one's too bad. We won't go to the police. And I thought, crikey, we wouldn't have said that 3 years ago if we looked at an email like that.
The specialist unit dealing with MP security based at Scotland Yard is now assessing the threat during this campaign. This election campaign will see an unprecedented police-led focus on protecting candidates. In a statement issued to ITV News this evening, the Met Police says it's working with forces around the country to ensure effective security measures are in place. These will be continually reviewed in the run-up to the election, and allegations of abuse or intimidation will be treated very seriously. Offenders, they say, will be pursued relentlessly. This winter campaign has now begun, but the threats and precautions mean it's getting off to a much darker start. Angus Walker, News at 10, Westminster.